All right. Day three.
Woohoo!
Day three back in the studio. Brent is making his special coffee. Can't see. Don't see.
We're starting with the finest beans. Guatemala Antigua. Medium. Starbucks.
Oh.
We have the Tim Hortons bun coffee maker.
Which keeps
the water heated.
Yeah. Check it out.
And it should be a fine cup of coffee.
So he makes coffee with hair on it. Yeah.
Stand
and we're just getting yesterday was first day, and we got lots of great stuff done. Third day now is really the second day recording, so I've got some Gatorade to stay keep those electrolytes up, and crispers, they're not as bad as chips, but I can eat carrots, okay? So bite me. And a couple of bars. These are the ones Patty tells me that they're good, that they're healthy. They basically taste like bark.
They taste like sawdust. My wife's been trying to convince me. They're terrible. I don't recommend the all-brand bars. It's compressed sawdust. It's all it's
okay. Okay, then I got these aren't as healthy, but these are delicious. Yeah, the Nutri-Grain. These are a little bit bad. But, we got some of those and some crispers in case we're getting hungry. I'm going to have a coffee and a Nutri-Grain bar because I didn't even have breakfast. I tried to resolve my issue with the line 6 thing. They didn't send me, I don't know if I told you. Buy the Variax, get the Podex T free. So call an 800 number and you get this.
Hello?
Oh my God.
Hello?
Oh God. So I try to explain to her.
So what? We sent you rebate?
Oh my God. And I tell her the whole story of buying the, I buy the base and you get the pod free. But no, she puts me on hold for 10 minutes, comes back and goes,
so you will not get the software. It's
not software. It's hardware. You plug your amp with.
How much does it cost? I don't want the money. I want the pod.
I said, never mind. I'll call them directly. Oh, my God.
Hello.
Nothing against someone Eastern European, you come here, you're going to work hard, but you know what? If you're in customer service, it helps if you can talk to the customers. Please. Anyway, enough of my ranting. So we'll get started here soon. We're just getting set and going to get ready and start day three of recording of day two. And good news, I talked to my brother. And it looks like he's going to be coming down on Thursday. So we're going to have him do one of the songs. So, cool.
Okay. I have no comment on the size of your ass, which is what we were talking about in Silence. It was a silent movie for a while. But I do have a comment that I don't have a proper drum throne for any size ass. So, unfortunately, you're slumming it a little bit with that drum throne.
Nice. Real nice. So, we were talking about the fact that I've been sitting on the drum throne for a while. And drum throne is a drum stool. And it's a very small thing. It's not like a big easy chair. And get sore after a while.
I got it for free when I bought my symbols. What do you want? What do you want?
Nothing, nothing, nothing. Everything's cool. Yeah. So we're just getting healthy here.
Look at this.
Dr. Tom. Mm. But you're happy with things, Brent?
Absolutely. Yeah. Rock and roll, baby. Sounds fantastic.
Yeah. Me too. Okay. Get the hell out of here and let us eat in peace. So ends day three in the studio, and it was quite a day. This was a tough one. My arm is killing me. Hands are sore. Look at that. But it was a great day. I learned a lot. I found that there were parts of songs, again, that didn't work, rhythmically speaking, that I had to change. And one specifically, Brent came up with an excellent idea. There's an incredible drummer, Manu Katché, and if you're Peter Gabriel fan or Sting fan, then you'll know Manu, and it's like, do a Manu, and Manu plays the toms, as you probably saw if I recorded that one. And Manu will play, instead of a typical cymbal or hi-hat thing, it's all tom, so it was like very rhythmic and cool. So I had to learn that, and it was interesting. And then finally get it in the pocket, as they call it, and then record it. And that took us a while. And then I had some trouble with one song, and it was in 6/8. So instead of regular time, it's, think of counting like a fast. What am I thinking here? Kind of like a fast waltz. I'm a little bit distracted here as I'm trying to finish the other taping there. I had problems with the recording the end of day two, which hopefully I have up by now. This is day three. So I've got that on my mind. Get the video on the web. Thanks to everybody who has replied. I really appreciate your wonderful words of encouragement. And tomorrow we're back at it. And my brother Dave has agreed. I'm going to call him in about an hour and see what time he's going to come down. But he's going to play drums on one of the songs. And it's going to be a very, very special time. So we'll see you tomorrow.